My name's Corinne. This is my 13th minimum wage job.
I say hello and scan groceries.
4.40 change.
Have a nice day.
And yeah. I know it. Straight away, looking down at me.
Dumb bitch, should've gone to university or TAFE and got herself a real job. What's a 32-year-old doing working at Coles?
I am.
Beep, 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 beep. At university, they tell me I have low SES.
They say it's statistically unlikely that I will change my socioeconomic status due to my income, education, and occupation.
And I have a kid, so that's about all there is to it.
$82, please.
Hey, I dodged the bullet if you ask me. I should be fucking fat like Cherie over there.
Do you have a two-money chance?
Thank you.
Truth is, I have climbed to the top. Job one was at the butcher's. I got $12.20 an hour and cleaned guts and bone off perspex. When I wasn't selling red-faced men and their cram-pushing wives steak and sausages.
Enjoy your lamb shanks!
Hey, you think that's better than this cushy job? I tell you, this is the upper management of the service industry.
Unexpected item in the mailing area.
If you can hear that voice over there, that's the Coles robot bitch who took five of our jobs.
They brought in the self-checkout machines a year ago, or as we call them here, the free fruit machines. See, you put your fruit straight.
Sorry? I gave you $7.80, ma'am. It cost $12.20 and you gave me a 20. I'm certain, ma'am, says how much change to give you on your receipt.
Sorry, gosh, bitch, can't count. You put the fruit wedge straight into your bag and walk away and no one knows you've nicked it. Still cost them less than 5 wages, so they don't much care.
And that's the problem with the minimum wage circuit. We're nothing but robots being phased out by robots. I don't just mean scanning and the giving of change, I mean the whole thing. It has screwed for Christ's sakes.
My name's Corinne and I'll be your Subway sandwich artist today. Would you like cornmeal, five grade cheese or Italian herbs?
Everything we say to you is word for word on the script. The small talk beyond
how was your day
is rarer than a customer who tips. My conversations are much broader than those had by that electronic piece of shit over there.
This was $4.65 and not $4.80, you reckon?
One moment, please. Price check on Red Bull Twin Pack.
Price check on Red Bull Twin Pack.
You know, it's amazing how much you can tell about someone in the 1 minute they take to pass through my checkout. This guy here, he's into porn and video games. No one else buys nothing but energy drinks.
You can tell if someone's married, has kids. You can tell their income from their brand choices, how smart they are, how good they are at math.
Tree records is meant to be $4.80. Maybe you looked at the wrong price tag?
You can tell how this woman don't get fucked near as often as they want. Most people think they're better than people like me, but I can see everything that's wrong with their lives in a second. The only difference is they get paid triple what I do to hate their jobs.
A few years ago, I hated what I was doing much more than I do now. Job four was delivering flyers in the suburbs. Worked out to be 4 cents per house. Dogs would chase me and it rained all the fucking time. And those hardcore metal mailbox flaps that are so hard.
Job seven was the bakery. Didn't get paid extra for starting at 4 a.m. And the prick of a franchise owner fined me for taking a bag of old bread from the skip.
Next stop, Macca's. Would you like fries with your unfair dismissal?
The point is, I did a lot of shitty jobs and it doesn't get any better than Coles. The only place I can go to from here is Aldi. Those bastards get to sit all day and their scanners are the total business. They're the checkout princes and they know it.
Welcome to Aldi. My name's Corinne. I finished in 10 minutes, but I'm not grumpy because my feet aren't getting. You want a plastic bag for that bag of bread? You'll actually have to pay for one.
Here I am at the peak of the low SES world, worrying about another redundancy. I have it made here, 30 to 40 hours a week.
Beep.
A few bucks per hour of minimum wage.
Beep.
Decent manager.
Beep.
Close to home.
Beep.
Always know the specials.
Beep.
The free fruit machine doesn't have a kid to feed or a lazy husband to cook for when it gets home. It doesn't have to feel bad for being a robot, because that's exactly what it is.
Cigarettes check out for only, sir. Well, there's no point yelling at me. You didn't design the store layout.
Go and fuck myself.
Have a nice day. Why is it store policy never to swear at a customer? Guys like this angry bogan here get to say whatever they want, and I have to bite my tongue. As cool as my manager is, I'll be out my
ask. I dished out, dished to me.
Cigarettes at checkout 4. And why don't you take them home and stick one up into that girl's ass cunt? So she gets to make something bigger than a matchstick up there.
Those thin lipped Weight Watchers woman's weekly cows. They sneer at you when you ask them how they're doing.
You know what, man? Why don't you head on over to the club on Queen Street and get some of the regulars to take you out there? You quite clearly need a good hard fucking, and you don't even need to say hello!
We need to learn to speak our mind before progress takes our livelihoods. Let's say and do what we tell about me for a change.
Here's your photo, Kim. Would you like to put your come on my face with that?
Back to the bottom of the bottom.
These bastards could afford to keep us and it wouldn't make a difference.